morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Crews have finally fixed a broken water main along Elm Street in Manchester's North End, but the road will likely be closed for most of the day while repairs are made to the road surface. The main broke yesterday afternoon and the roadway buckled. Elm Street is closed between West Clark and Thayer Streets. It is not clear right now exactly what caused the break, but officials say there is a lot of older infrastructure in the city. Three bills aimed at tackling the state's drug crisis are on the fast track now. They could be on Governor Maggie Hassan's desk next month. The legislation includes harsher penalties for fentanyl dealers, studying increased distribution of Narcan, and requiring drug education in schools. Other bills focused on prevention, treatment, and recovery will either go through the normal legislative process or receive early recommendation, meaning they'll be voted on as soon as possible when the full legislature returns to normal session. A man who witnessed the killing of an Epsom police officer and then fired shots during the getaway is back behind bars this morning. Kevin Paul had his parole revoked yesterday, just 7 months after it was granted. Paul was with Gordon Perry back in 1997 when Perry shot and killed Epsom police officer Jeremy Sharon. Paul pleaded guilty to several charges related to that crime and was sentenced to 16 to 50 years in prison. Yesterday, the board found that Paul violated 10 of the 13 complaints filed against him that include a drug offense and failing to report to his parole officer.
Well, it's clear that you can't take him at his word. His words mean nothing, and quite frankly, it appears that he thinks your words mean nothing. If you're going to say zero tolerance, with all due respect, it's got to be zero tolerance. Today is the or else day you keep telling this defendant about.
And Paul was sent back to prison for 2 years. He can apply to go before the parole board every 6 months. A Hudson woman is in a Boston hospital this morning with serious injuries after she was hit by an SUV while walking through a parking lot last night. Police say 59-year-old Pamela Stoltz was walking outside Dunkin' Donuts when she was hit just after 5 o'clock. The driver of the SUV was not hurt, and police say drugs, alcohol, or speed were not factors. Manchester police are investigating a pair of robberies, including one frightening exchange. Check it out. In this surveillance video from Sean's Corner Market Monday night, you can see a man armed with a knife jump over the counter and then fight with the clerk while ordering him to open the register. He did get away with some cash. Hours later, someone tried to rob the 7-Eleven on Queen City Avenue, but the clerk grabbed a phone and locked herself inside the office. Police are still trying to figure out if the cases are connected. New statistics show that New Hampshire has one of the highest high school graduation rates in the country. About 88% of Granite State students graduated last year. The national rate is 82%. Iowa has the highest graduation rate at 90%, followed by Nebraska, New Jersey, and Texas. New Hampshire came in fifth. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.